Welcome to Design Hub, this project specially based on truss design. This truss is Pratt type truss, which comes under roof truss category. And this types of truss, mostly used for lightweight roof. Vertical member provide gravity load, which act in downward direction, and wind uplift load, act in upward direction. So both are nullify each other. Most of the Pratt truss, made by lightweight structure member. First assumption for design and analysis of truss, the centroidal axis of each member coincides with the line connecting the centers of the adjacent members, and the members only carry axial force. This is centroid axis, and this is member, and member always carry axial force like in tension, or in second assumption, all members are connected only at their ends by frictionless hinges in plane trusses. This is gusset plate, on the other hand we can say frictionless support, or hinge. Now we are coming on third assumption, this is very important, because all stress depend on this loading, all loads, and support reactions, are applied only at the joints. Let's start simulation study using solidwork. This provide accurate result in within a minute. Steps for stress analysis: first, we design a truss; second, we define all constraint and forces on the truss; third, result conclusion and compare with theoretical calculation. First, create a new simulation study. After that, go to the cut list, and all weldment member define as a truss. When you complete, then go to the constraint and define as per your requirement constraint. In this truss we have to define one end as a immovable, no translation, constraint. Then again define one more fixture, reference fixture with the reference of front plane. Now we are going to define middle point constraint. These fixtures help to restrict, tilt and bend in Z direction. Now we have to define a load on joint, as per third assumption. Now run the analysis and check the beam list forces and other stresses.